was a fan. Oh, look there. You see that head symbol? Listen, every head has a little bit of meow cheek to it. They react to places and objects that resemble them. Oh, why don't you just give it a try? Here, first choose the right head. Now, use the head's meow cheek. Anyway, keep an eye out for those head symbols. Anything could happen. Meow! Look at that. No wonder they're so skinny. Watch that feisty fork. It's as wicked as the witch. Hey, I warned you. When you pass through that shimmering gateway, to proceed to the back of the kitchen.
Now, make no mistake. Kutaro was not alone in his plight. The kitchen was already starved by unfortunates whom the Moon Bear King had plucked from their beds. These children have been charged with keeping the Fickle King fed, and it was a miserably hopeless task. After all, his appetite was as vast and insatiable as his lust for power.
Careful. There's this thing about fire and puppets. All those mute sparkles, you don't want to toast yourself grabbing them.
Spending dusk till dawn getting kneaded and grated, peeled and parboiled, marinated, melted, minced and mashed. Just zesty, followed by a light.
I smell something delicious. And that was my mouse. Oh, there's a spark of magic in every egg. Got any ideas? There's that head symbol again. See how using your head can change the world? And it will mean that quite literally.
The witch, in case you're wondering, was a singularly screwy sorceress by the name of Esma Poppins. You'd think someone that gifted with a cauldron would know a thing or two about cooking. And in a bit of as for Kutaro's catty companion, name of Inyo, he used to be the moon goddess's faithful feline. One might say his current mistress was a step down in some regard.